I said this before and I'll say it again. This is an amazing little camera. Besides being super convenient to use and recording amazing looking footage, it actually has quite a few professional features for when you need more out of your camera. One of these is the ability to record in a 10-bit D-Log M color profile. Today, I'm going to show you how to utilize the tools included in Final Cut Pro to make D-Log M footage look good. And full disclosure, I am not a colorist, nor am I claiming to be one, and I'm going to be using a lot of auto settings. If you are a colorist, this might be painful to watch, so either move on to the next video or at least unplug your keyboard so you're not tempted to tell me how much I suck in the comments. With all that out of the way, let's get started. First of all, straight out of the camera, log footage does not look good. It's flat, doesn't have much color, and just looks bad. So why would you shoot log? Well, a human eye can see about 24 stops of light. A camera sensor, like the one in the Osmo Pocket 3, can pick up about 12 to 14 stops of light. A standard SDR video file is about 6 stops. Anything outside of this range is cut off. What this means is we lose detail in everything outside of our 6 stop rectangle. Anything above will be pure white, and anything below, complete black. When you shoot in a log profile, a logarithmic equation is applied to your input signal. This compresses the 12 to 14 stops of light your sensor picks up and squishes it so it fits inside a standard video file. Same as done with color. So when you color grade your footage, you have all that information to work with instead of the detail and highlights or shadows being completely lost. If you want a better explanation of this, Dana did it. I'll link his video down below. So what do we do with this footage? Well, first of all, we need to bring this into the standard Rec. 709 color space. The best way to do this is with a camera LUT. What I recommend is using DJI's D-Log M LUT specifically designed for this footage. Go to DJI's download page and download the Osmo Pocket 3 D-Log M to Rec. 709 LUT. I highly recommend starting here. Trying to color correct log footage manually requires a lot of skill and knowledge, so it's a lot easier to use a LUT. Next, let's jump into Final Cut Pro and I'll show you how to add custom camera LUTs to your footage. Select your clip, either in your media browser or in your timeline, and go up to the inspector window. Select the info inspector, and down at the bottom, switch from the basic view to extended. In the extended view, you should see a few new categories, including camera LUT. If you open this dropdown, as you can see, Final Cut Pro comes with a number of camera LUTs pre-installed for some of the more popular cameras, including DJI's D-Log, but no LUT for D-Log M. We need the specific LUT, because if you try the D-Log LUT, it does not look good. To install the proper LUT you just downloaded, open the camera LUT dropdown again, and down at the bottom, select Add Custom Camera LUT. Select your downloaded LUT and click Open. This imports your LUT into Final Cut Pro and automatically adds it to your clip. Another way of adding custom LUTs to your footage is by using the custom LUT effect, and there is one advantage to doing it this way. We'll get to it in a bit. Let's remove this LUT from our footage and go to the effects browser. Select the color category, grab the custom LUT effect, and add it to your clip. The LUTs for this effect are stored in a different place in Final Cut Pro, so you have to add it just like before. Open the LUT dropdown, select Choose Custom LUT, and navigate to your downloaded LUT again. Click Add to add this LUT to your clip. The advantage of adding LUTs as an effect is you get the mix slider, so if you want to dial it down a bit, it's an option. Simply adding a proper camera LUT to your log footage makes it look good, but you can fine-tune it to make it look even better. You can do this manually, or if you're in Final Cut Pro 10.8 or higher, you can use the new Enhanced Light and Color feature and let Final Cut Pro use machine learning to do what it thinks your image needs to look better. With your clip selected in the timeline, open the Color Balance dropdown and select Enhanced Light and Color. Final Cut Pro will analyze your clip and add the necessary adjustments. Unlike the balanced color option, where you had zero control, any changes made with this new feature are fully adjustable. Go back to the inspector window and select the color inspector. This will automatically take you to color adjustments, where you can see exactly what Final Cut Pro did to your image. The light and color categories are separated, so you can manually adjust one while keeping the automatic adjustments on the other. As soon as you make any adjustments, the enhance button turns gray, letting you know these parameters have been adjusted manually. This lets you tweak your image until it looks just the way you want. If you ever need to go back to the auto settings, simply click the enhance button again. The button turns blue and the adjustments go back to what Final Cut Pro thinks your footage needs. with just a few simple steps and without the need to know much about color grading, we just took our flat log footage from a DJI Osmo Pocket 3 and made it look much better. Of course, if you're shooting log, you probably want to color grade your footage yourself and make it look as good as it can. I can't really help you there, but my friend Dylan John can. He made a complete course about color grading in Final Cut Pro, and trust me, after going through it, I guarantee your videos will look better. I'll link it down below. Go check it out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.